And we're back in Stone-Bear Hold to start the assault on the Vinter Fortress.
When you are ready, you have our blades, Inquisitor.
I'm ready to attack the jaws of Hakkon.
Good. They will pay the blood price for what they have done. Your Scald and your Scout are here. We can plan the assault.
Oh, I like the sound of Scald. It's more dramatic than Professor. Yes. Well, everything we've found out about Inquisitor Ameridan suggests that he never emerged from that Tevinter fortress.
If that is where your Inquisitor defeated Hakkon, that is where the jaws of Hakkon must perform the rite to free him.
Ideally, we stop them before that. I'd rather not fight an Avvar god if we don't have to.
You really have no problem with us killing your god?
Gods cannot be reborn until they die. Hakkon needs a good rebirthing.
If you say so.
With its ice wall melted, the fortress is open to attack. We must strike soon, before our foes recover.
They're already trying. I've got most of our forces defending the shrine from Hakkonites who want to restore the wall.
If anyone has suggestions, now is the time.
What gives you fear, Inquisitor? Is this not the battle you wanted?
I'm no warrior, but with Lady Harding's forces defending the shrine and no way to breach the walls...
Lowlanders, why not climb the walls?
Your warriors can get over those walls before the Hakkonites stop them?
This is not a war, Stone Daughter. This is a raid. We strike at night. Clad lightly. We climb the wall and open the gate from inside.
If Stone-Bear Hold can open the gates, we would be grateful.
The jaws of Hakkon have been bugs in my bedroll for months, Inquisitor. We owe you thanks.
Inquisition forces will feign weakness near the shrine. That'll draw some of them away from the fortress.
Not too many, I hope.
Yes, save some for us.
Right, Inquisitor. Hask and I will climb over.
I'll be there to catch Parv when he slips.
Of course you will. You'll be behind me after all.
Hopefully no one tells the Chantry folk about this little raid.
I've got him.
They'll be... probably a little upset with me bringing the Divine.
Death to her husband for Hakkon's glory!
And we have a bear. Hooray!
Dead!
Were true to their word. No sign of the dragon. It must be in there.
Thank you.
really annoying.
Kill a dive warrior!
See if there's still a bug here. Yep. And I'm dying. You try to loot that. Deal with that is.
Hissing, freezing magic!
This cold is magical in origin. It will kill us if we do not hurry.
Better, right? Might even keep our toes.
Yep, unfortunately. None of the four made it out of here. Shouldn't the veil fire keep us warm?
He's summoning Hakkon into his own body.
Is he insane?
Obviously.
Harofson, called the Cutter, Wyvern Slayer, Lowland Bane.
The Blight doesn't discriminate.
Bring his body, bloody blessings, cold and pain!
Or something.
father. Priest of Korth the Callow. Leave the lady lost and lonely. Scour the skies of spirits sallow. Born in battle, bloody bladed. Winter's breath to rack the lowlands, cold to cut and kill the hated.
What I'm gonna have to do here. I don't wanna have to do it, but I gotta go back and refill my grenades. Okay, we're good to go now. save it.
Leave the lady lost and lonely. Scour the skies of spirits sour. Gerd Harofson, called the Cutter, Wyvern Slayer, Lowland Bear. Face of Hakkon, bring his body, bloody blessings, cold and pain!
This boss can be rather difficult if you don't take him down quick. But I'm gonna try to burn him down before we can
called
do anything.
Called the Cutter, Wyvern Slayer, Lowland Bear. His body, bloody blessings, cold and pain! Sing the song of savage hack. Born in battle, bloody bladed. Winter's breath to rack the moment. Cold to cut and kill the hated.
Okay. Actually, I'm gonna replace that instead. Okay, here we go.
Others. We can't hurt Hakkon. Until they're out.
Leave the lady locked.
Great.
Thank you.
Place me in... could not stand against me. You shall fall as well.
Destroyed. That is why I brought Sarah right there. The game right here.
Inquisitor.
Inquisitor? How fares Draken? Has he brought the chant to the whole world yet?
Inquisitor Ameridan, you disappeared in 120 Divine, around the time of the signing of the Navarran Accord.
You say it as though it was... How long?
You were the last Inquisitor. There has not been another since you disappeared 800 years ago.
Draken was my oldest friend. He would have sent someone to find me.
I'm afraid Draken was a little busy with the darkspawn pouring down from the Anderfels.
I see. Tilana escaped the battle. Did she... Do the records say what became of her?
He knows when you lie.
She returned to the island. From what we can tell, she died trying to reach you through dreams.
I asked her not to. She was a good hunter and the love of my life, but she never... I never wanted this job. Hunting demons was so much simpler than politics.
Inquisitor Ameridan, how could the leader of the Seekers be a mage?
Has history forgotten so much? I was not a seeker myself, as most Inquisitors were. I used my magical gifts in the hunting of demons and Maleficarum. Do the Seekers no longer welcome the aid of mages?
No, that was forgotten, among many other things.
Cassandra is a seeker, and after the Seekers went rogue, she discovered the truth about them.
We learned they developed the Rite of Tranquility.
You mean sundering one from the Fade? The Seekers do it briefly when granting an initiate their abilities.
It has become a way to control mages deemed dangerous. They are left tranquil, permanently.
Killing a man is ugly work. You learn not to look to it as your first recourse. Sundering them from the Fade is easy. Bloodless. I told them spreading such a solution would lead to abuse. They swore that would never happen. They promised. I am so sorry.
Cassandra will rebuild the Seekers into an organization to be proud of again, with the Inquisition's help.
Then you both have my thanks. I was a good hunter. I did not want to lead an organization, but Draken told me I was needed. As I suspect you were needed.
It hasn't all been bad.
I am glad to hear it. And sorry to burden you with my unfinished business. The dragon carries the spirit of an Avvar god. I lacked the strength to kill it. My own magic was able to bind us all, locked in time. But when the cultists drew that spirit into another vessel, it disrupted my bindings. It is breaking free.
Yep, we've killed self-proclaimed gods.
I killed the would-be god who unleashed the blight upon the world. He had a dragon too.
Then I leave the world in good hands. The passage of years can be delayed, but not ignored. I will soon join Tilana at Andraste's side. Take this. It holds the last few memories of an old hunter who was neither as wise nor as strong as he thought. Fight well, Inquisitor. I am honored to have met you.
We need to stop the dragon. It still carries the spirit of Hakkon.
We ended that fight so fast that I didn't get the trophy for lighting all the fires and whatnot, but whatever. That's why I saved it right before this. Crazy is that the Inquisitor being a not only an elf but a elven mage seeker. So much was just forgotten. If he had survived, then it wouldn't have been. The Dalish would have fought in the Second Blight. There would have been no Exalted March on the Dales. One more dragon hunt for Inquisitor Trevelyan. And we are actually going to get all of the Inquisitor's memories before we kill the dragon. This inscription implies that Razakale is a female dragon, unlike the other old gods.
Myself in as well, but I have little choice.
This beast will wreak devastation across Orlais unless we stop it now.
He saved all of Orlais from the Avvar, and no one ever knew.
People don't do things so you know them. Good on him.
Change party momentarily just for a bit of dialogue.
Friends on my side. Delana and Heron have been arguing about Heron using delirium to fight demons. Some things never change. Arina has a new alchemical trick she wants to try, like pitch or tar, but stronghold. A recipe straight from Vorzamar. They argue, fuss, and mock each other mercilessly. And I would be lost without them.
Yes. What's that like?
A dwarf getting on someone's nerves. I can't imagine.
This Orina sounds like good people.
Sounds a lot like our little crew, huh? Fussing and arguing. Inquisitor would be lost without them.
Inquisitor Ameridan, who helped bring the Inquisition into the Chantry, built the shrine for the Maker and the Elven gods.
Belief is a funny thing. An Elven Inquisitor must have had a careful path to walk.
Next one? You know what? He's a liability. But I'm gonna bring Iron Bull to kill the dragon. I think. I may change my mind before we get there.
Thank you.
waste time to chase the thing. Just gonna wait for it. No! Damn it. Well, I just realized I was an Xbox controller.
Elves ignored the second blight as it spread across Orlais. So began the animosity that led to the destruction of the Dales.
So, the ancient Hakkonite assholes didn't destroy the lowlands like they wanted, but they did get the elves.
Yep. The Dales destroyed because of these Avvar. Partially. The elves could have helped with the blight, but obviously they didn't. Just hold up a minute, Dragon. I'll be right with you.
I could do without all the demons, boss. Anytime you want to leave, it's fine by me.
No demons here anymore.
You should be at Hallam Shirao reminding our people of our alliance with Draken. here, risking death with me. Still, in the old tongue, your name, Talanadas, means nothing is inevitable. I will remember your name and hope.
A dreamer like Talana would be sensitive to demons. This spirit of Hakkon would have caused her a great deal of pain.
More pain than watching her husband and all her fighting buddies get killed.
Yep, Inquisitor Ameridan. Pretty damn impressive character for how little we know of him.